Now, while the president is away in the Netherlands doing the good work and the vice president is here in Nigeria also doing well, here we'll be taking all the boxes containing options gauging how much work is being done by the administration in two key national sectors. It is part of our countdown to the one-year anniversary of President Bola Tinubu's administration. And we will get right into it now with Naija Atu Tijani and Mayor Ogidi speaking to issues in the defense and solid minerals sector. I would like to begin, welcome you both to Network News.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jomai.
Well, I think it's best to start with Naija Atu. Why don't you take a look at the targets there on the screen and tick whatever options that best describe developments within the defense sector in the last 1 year. Naija.
Thank you, Jomai. Let's begin with intelligence gathering. Now, you'll see that each of these boxes here is closely related to the first one, which is intelligence gathering, where we have counterinsurgency. And later on, you'll see how military logistics also come into play. Now, one of the challenges that is happening in terms of security in the nation when it comes to intelligence gathering is ensuring it's a dicey balance and the lines are blurred in the sense that the ones giving the information, those who are giving the information, the security operatives want to ensure that they are safe. In the past, it was noted that some of these communities which gave information were usually attacked by some of these terrorists, but in recent times that has greatly reduced. But it's still a dicey balance in the sense that intelligence gathering, when properly harnessed, will lead to a lot of successes and progress. Now, if you take a comparative analysis and you look at some of the reports that NTA has done on counterinsurgency, you will see that the Joint Task Force and also the Operation Hattenkay, that's the Air Task Force, as well as the Nigerian Army working together, uses intelligence to, of course, overcome the terrorists and the bandits. Notwithstanding, if information is not being given, and this was in a chat that was taken earlier on with the Minister of Defense, they rely heavily on cooperation and, of course, information. So when you note that counterinsurgency successes are going on, it's directly related to intelligence gathering. However, at this point in time, enough is not being done that will impact widely. So while the security operatives are doing okay, using the information they have to protect the nation, it still needs realignment. So when it comes to intelligence gathering, I'll say this it still needs realignment. It's not yet on course, but it needs realignment. So we talked about the two of them concurrently because it is what you get here that directly impacts counterinsurgency. And in a recent chat with the Minister of Defense, it was revealed that some of the notorious bandit leaders have been killed. They've been eliminated. Their hideouts followed to their hideouts, and their hideouts have been destroyed, all thanks to the intelligence that we're given, some from the communities, and of course, however, it takes a while, of course, to do some of these investigations because there has to be verification in order to eliminate any error so as not to have any incidents of hitting the wrong target. So far, so good with the elimination of bandit leaders, terrorist leaders, commanders and their hideouts. The military and, of course, the defense sector is on course in this particular area. There are a lot of statistics, there are a lot of reports, there are a lot of weekly updates when it comes to counterinsurgency. And another thing that impacts these two directly, of course, is military logistics. And this includes the planning and, of course, acquisition of equipment and platform, which recently, I'll give you an example, the Nigerian Navy has been steadily acquiring and increasing its fleet, the same as the Nigerian Air Force, which is expecting some M346 aircraft and others. There is so much, but in this area so far, and before I quickly wrap up, I'll say military logistics is on course, but I want to quickly wrap up by saying that the Ministry of Defense is taking charge in the sense that it will soon ensure that military uniforms And some of these, it will look inwards to ensure that military uniforms are manufactured right here in the country so that civilians and other outsiders do not have access to this. So I'm going to stop here for now. Intelligence gathering needs realignment, counterinsurgency and military logistics are on course so far.
Thank you so much, Nada, to our defense correspondent. You've given a definite, you know, analysis of the defense sector. Next is Mayor Ogidi. He's our man in the solid mineral sector with ears to the ground. Now, Mia, I would like for you to do some quick review of the targets we have lined up for you and tick options that suit the situation in your opinion.
Thank you, Jumai. Let's start with mining regulations. Revocation of licenses within 1 year, that is November 2023, 1,163 were revoked, and just yesterday, 924 revoked. And on CDA, that is Community Development Agreements, January 30th, 2024, the present administration reviewed the agreements to ensure that communities also have that impact of the process. So on that aspect, I think they're on course. Regulations are being reviewed and those that are not performing revoked. On foreign direct investment, the Minister Dele Alakye and that of the President himself on various occasions have engaged foreign partners. Like in Doha, when the President was in Qatar on the sidelines, the Minister had some discussions with foreign investors. And that of United States and Nigeria, they have a working group. U.S. is represented by the special advisor to the president of U.S. to work out modalities on how U.S. can invest in the sector in Nigeria. And the minister of mines and solid mineral, Dele Alakye, is also the pioneer chairman of African Ministers Group. And that is a forum where foreign investment within African countries that are producing solid minerals can drive foreign investment into their respective countries. So on that aspect too, the ministry is quite on course. And finally, on value addition, it is with the present administration's policy that they will never let raw materials, raw solid minerals, to get out of their country. They must be refined there. And within this 1 year, two major factories, lithium factories, have been, taken off in the country, one in Nasarawa, and just today, another one in the Wase area of Abuja. And the essence of it is that the benefits in terms of employment and finished products and revenue from it will be invested here in Nigeria instead of taking those raw materials out of the country for the benefit of outsiders. So on the issue of value addition, the ministry is also on course. Jumai, thank you very much. And that is the much we can take at this moment.
Thank you, Mayor Ogidi, for your in-depth analysis. And of course, I would like to thank Naja Atutijani as well, who joined us earlier. We appreciate you.
Thank you very much.